Tested every year, and it's being tested with 200,000 or 300,000 people with the carnival, the famous carnival. So Sambódromo, the venue for archery in Rio 2016, and the test event coming in September.
What a relief for the people who were able to qualify here in Copenhagen. They know a year out now that they're going to be in Rio.
It's a huge difference to know that you have a quota place. The support, the fans, is totally different than if you have to get the quota place during now until May next year.
All right, here we go. The women's team gold medal match. Usually we see South Korea. In fact, since 2003, South Korea has been in this gold medal match on 5 occasions out of the 6 opportunities. Italy snuck in there in 2011 in Torino, and they won the women's team gold medal back then. But here today, it is Russia taking on India. And the first team out of the King's Gate is the team from the Russian Federation, which had a strong week, registering 5-3 victories over Ukraine, a 6-0 win over Mexico, and then winning a tiebreaker against the Korean team that you just watched win a bronze medal. This Russian team comprised of Ina Stepanova in the middle, Ksenia Perova, and on the left, Tuyana Dashidorjeva, a 19-year-old. So from left to right, it's Dashidorjeva, Perova, and Stepanova, the three archers from the Russian Federation. And today they will take on an equally strong team from India. India with a 5-3 victory over Germany earlier this week. Then they went up against Colombia and came away with a 6-2 win before going to a shoot-off against Japan and winning that shoot-off against Japan. So they make the long walk from the King's Gate out to the shooting line here at the Palace Square, Christian Borg Palace in beautiful Copenhagen, Denmark, on an idyllic Sunday morning, beautiful Sunday morning, packed grandstands, great atmosphere, great setting, as we get set for the women's gold medal match. And let's meet the three archers from India who will be competing here today against the Russian Federation. Deepika Kumari, 21 years old, on your left. There's Deepika. Deepika, ranked 8th in the world, was number 1 in the world back in 2012, and she'll be teaming up with Laxmarani Maji and Rimil Buriuli. Buriuli, 24 years of age, and Maji, 26 years of age. But clearly the leader of this Indian team is Deepika Kumari.
Deepika is a similar story than Kibo Bey in many sense. She has been struggling after London, and she was out of the team for a while, but came back very strong this year. She find the confidence back again, and she has been working really hard to go back to the international level that she deserves. And she has a great talent, young archer, and working very hard to get ready for Rio.
You're former Olympic archer. You know what it's like after the games. There's a little bit of a letdown, and it's tough to maintain that level of intensity, I think, for that period between the games you just competed in and the upcoming games.
Let's say depends on the result. If you did your goal and you did a good result, it's a different situation than if you fail and you feel like you lost an opportunity or you did really, really bad. So when there's a lot of expectation on yourself or your federation, on the people around, the media, the country, on your result, and you don't deliver it, it's a tough year afterward that you lost a lot of confidence, you don't understand why. There's so many things happen in Olympic. But when you deliver and you do much more than expected, it's a different situation. Probably it's a little bit of more relaxing. I did my job, and let's have a couple of months that even if you want to do something, no one let you.
Right.
You're going from sponsor to sponsor, from media to media, and then you focus again several months after. So in the case of Deepika, she has not a good result in London, as expected. She expected to have much more. The federation and the country expected a medal. And she struggled a little bit to come back, but she's a tough and talented archer, and she's back.
And you can see it right there with
we
that 10.
You can see determination, good form, confidence, decision. She has it all. The princess of India.
Yes. She tacks on the first 10 of this match for either of these teams, and her.
We can see as the first team also a bit on right. So it seems that the condition and the practice feel a bit different, because we have seen already 3 teams that the first arrows go a little bit on the right.
The practice field is behind the Christian Borg Palace, back by the showgrounds for the royal stable of horses.
90 steeds. Degrees different orientation.
Yes.
We tried to keep it parallel in same orientation. Was not possible. And this is the price that we have to pay when we come to iconic places. Sometimes
sure.
it's not possible to do what we would like to do. The only thing is it's fair for both teams. Both teams has the same situation.
Exactly. So right now, Russia's on a run of nines. Stepanova starting off with a nine. Now here's Perova, Ksenia Perova, 28 years old, a student who's won 48 matches in her career, averages just about nine per arrow,
it's
and
a
comes
good
up with another nine.
It's a good surprise, the Russian team, the women team, was not expected they would perform so well, and it's clear that for several years they have not been in the level that everybody expect, but they are back. They came like out of the sudden, we could not see it coming, and all the teams could not see it coming, but Russia has always delivered good archers, and they were struggling in the last 5-6 years to deliver or to go on the level internationally that they used to be. But the Olympic preparation has helped them a lot, and they are looking forward for Rio. They are aiming to Rio.
Right now, Deepika Kumari aiming for that center circle, and she finds it. Some of the amazing architecture in the background here, making this such a tremendous setting. You saw that tower a moment ago. That's at the Stock Exchange here in Copenhagen, Denmark, as that shot lines up in the suburbs.
This is a present you don't want to give to another team, especially a team with the set system.
That's the first real true errant shot of the match for India. And a 10 would certainly help make up for that.
And
there you go, the 10. Good. Right there for Lakshmarani Manji.
They get rid of this this mistake. This here we see Deepika playing the role that Kibo Bae is playing in the Korean team. She's the one have the leadership. She's the one that has experience and put the team together. We see Stanislav Zabrowski, one of our best archers for many years, world record archer, world champion, coaching the Russian team since many years. He was coaching the Spanish team when I left Spain, and a coach with a lot of experience, and who is used to deliver good result and medal. As we used to say, a tough guy.
A tough guy.
We can see the Falco Eye target. This is an electronic system we are using to get the results automatically by laser scanners. And we can define exactly the position of the arrow. So accurate that we can see here the result system before the judges go to the target. If there is a difference of millimeter when we have to make the closest to the center. It's a system that's going to be used in the Olympic Games, and we are starting to use it in more and more events.
There will always be the need for judges, though, right,
always,
Carlos?
Always. You know, electronic and technology helps, but fails sometimes. So it's always the need to have the judge watching, and we are discussing the change of rule that we might adapt the electronic scoring as the score that is valid, and the archers might have a chance to challenge it, to have, like in tennis, a challenge, a couple of challenges to overrule if they feel it's not fair. But this is the future, and it's the present right now that will become more common in most of the important and international competitions.
It's amazing how technology is changing all sports, changing our entire world.
World archery always trying to improve the sport and bring in technology. We are a modern sport with a lot of history, and that's what we are doing in our events, trying to bring technology.
I like that.
To give more and more information to the audience, to the spectators, and the media.
Perova paints the eight ring. And Russia struggling right now here in this gold medal match against India.
As mentioned before, set system and team go very fast. You want to get the lead.
Dasha Georgieva out of the A ring as well. Dasha Georgieva vying for her first major medal. And she will go home with one. It's just a matter of which color it will be. There's the confidence of Deepika Kumari. You can see it in her eyes. But she
knew was not
veers off left.
We could see the reaction of the bow arm was not in the line to the target. It's a typical reaction when the archer and the clicker sound, this metal piece that make that give information is in front of the point right now, is hidden. When the clicker sounded, this metal pass, the archer shoots. And when the sight is not perfectly centered on one side, archers have the tendency to correct it.
We need to get you a telestrator so you can show us on the screen exactly.
That's talking about technology.
Yes, that's technology.
The next thing next to year. Come for next,
next
season.
Next year.
Let's do this. Excellent expansion.
So despite that 8 to open up this set, India has a one-point lead midway through this set, threatening to take a 4-0 lead in the match,
Russia.
The gold medal match.
Russia, no, they have to take the set. If not, they are in the hand of India.
Stepanova steps up.
We can see the timing and the decision of the archers make a big difference. When they shoot in a good time, you see action all the time, and a good decision most of the time is a 10. As soon as they start moving a little bit slower, hesitating, everything can happen. It's easy to
too
say,
much time to think.
It's easy to say when we are here relaxed.
Oh, yes.
Archers there can have 120 to 140 poles in their heart, and this adrenaline in the body make you think a little bit different.
Quick shot that time.
Yep.
Ashidorjeva in the nine ring.
Quick shots avoid you to think too much what is happening. You are just in action.
Confidently.
27 would tie the set, split the points. 28 would give the two set points to India. Kumari, who had an 8 on her first shot of this set.
10. That gives a relief to the other two archers, because if this arrow is not a 10, the next archers know they have to deliver a 10. But now it changes things. With a 10, you can be feel more relaxed. I just need to put it in the yellow.
And I think they changed their rotation. I don't think that was Deepika Kumari with that shot.
Nope. Archers are allowed, the team are allowed to change the order of shooting.
Yes.
And they used to do it to give, to work in the strategy, in the tactic. And probably they wanted to have Deepika having the last arrow because they know it's
change,
make a difference.
Yes.
Correct.
So that first shot was by Lakshmarani Maji. Muruyuli finished with a 9, and then now a 9 by Deepika Kumari.
This is where we can see that the coach know the archers and move them depending how the match is going. And in archery, there's not so much tactical strategy, but there is a little bit, and here we could see it.
And I think we'll see that in the upcoming match, in the men's bronze medal match with the United States. We saw that in Antalya with the United States, as Brady Ellison led off, and then he anchored.
Yep. Let's say that the team wanted to have Deepika, the most experienced archer, starting the match, starting the first arrow to make sure he's in the 10, in the middle. And then in this set, they knew that was very important to finish a good arrow, and they switched the position. Very smart. I can see that
it India's, makes a lot of sense.
India is working as a team.
Good coaching, great shooting,
any
great
coach,
preparation.
Any coach knows the weakness and the strength of the archer and has to play it in the right moment.
And you don't have to know who's mentally strong enough to take that last shot. So India shuffling the deck a little bit.
Probably this 7 that the previous archer shot make feel the coach that she was not ready to make the fast or the important shot in the last arrow and switch.
Great look at the crowd here.
Amazing.
Stands.
Fantastic.
You gotta love that.
I love it. I love it. We could see yesterday the spectators queuing to enter in the archery venue. It was a long queue. I took photos. It's amazing to see people coming to archery events and having the stands full.
Good coverage today in the local papers of Stefan Hansen and his victory in the men's compound yesterday. We'll talk more about that as this morning goes on. And Russia, with its back against the wall, comes out gunning. Dorjeva leads off with a 10.
They really need a strong and good start. They need to put in their pressure, because right now the pressure is under Russia. India is waiting to see what's happened and knowing they have a 4-0 lead, which is a very comfortable lead.
Ksenia Perova, who did win a World Cup gold medal at stage 3 in Ogden back in 2012, fires a 9. And now here's Ina Stepanova. And Stepanova steps up as well. So much stronger shooting in a desperate situation for the Russian Federation.
Deepika back to the first to shoot.
Kumari, the gold medalist from Antalya 2012, former Olympian, begins this set with a 9 for India.
short court. Confidently, will we finish our short court?
Laxmarani Maji lets it fly, and it's a nine as well.
We can hear the coach talk in the back, and archers very often don't listen exactly what they say, but it's a bit of support. You feel someone is behind, and you are not lonely in the shooting line, and give you a little bit more relaxed or confident. So very often the instruction, you don't hear what it's saying, but you feel a familiar voice behind that gives you confidence.
Oh, you can see on the release right there, Juan Carlos. Yes.
She knew what
she knew exactly as soon as she released.
And this is a sign of lack of focus. When she raised the ball to shoot, she was not focused enough to make it without thinking. So it was, you start with a doubt, and this doubt is keep going in the shot until the release is not so good. Russia is doing the job. Strong shot, good grouping in the center.
They are painting that center circle right now and battling to get back into this match. Perova. Who just missed out on team and individual medals in London, plants that one in the eight ring. That won't help. But a 10 right here from Stepanova would balance that out. She had a 10 on her last shot, and she comes close on this one.
But a good timing, good decision, good expansion. The shot was really good.
And so they have, for all intent and purposes, secured this set with those 56 points. Three tens right here would still leave India 1 point short.
Yes, they know this set is done. They should just go back to good feeling and shoot. They know there's no way to go back, but they should end this set by feeling confident they can do the next one.
String line check karke. Full mein finish out koi.
Perhaps that will carry over to the next set.
She needed that because after making a seven, you need to feel that you have done the mistake of the match, and that's all what you do. Now it's going back to center.
And Deepika finishes strong as well. So India will drop that set, though. And the match tightens up just a little bit, and the Russian Federation avoids elimination by winning that third set. And the match now goes to 4-2 in favor of India. But now there's some hope, and there's something to talk about in that huddle.
What is interesting in this kind of situation is the mindset change a lot. You feel that you have very little chance, and they give you this opportunity, and now you believe you can do it and come back. So the confidence in the archers when they're in a match is changing a lot from arrow to arrow, depends how it goes, and how your nerve or the anxiety or the adrenaline is working in your body and how much attention you put to it.
On the other hand, we were looking at Team India, and the body language was completely different.
Completely different. And we have seen it during the week that one set was really confident, say, wow, they are on fire, and the next one, like, what's happened? They're lost. And then they put them together again, and the next set was really on fire again and confident. So the mindset and the attitude of the archers changed during the match, depending on what's happened and how they feel. It's so much happening inside, the emotion, the mind of the archer that we don't see. That is, it's amazing for the coaches how to work this when you don't know what is happening inside the archer.
Much like the roller coaster ride at the Tivoli Gardens.
Yes, of course, observing the body language, knowing your archer and seeing the certain attitude can help you to guess what is happening inside the mind and the fears they have or the confidence they have, the level of confidence.
Let's see if that confidence carries over now into the fourth set for the Russian Federation. Still trailing, but now down 4-2. Strong shot right there, almost inside the 10 ring.
As Taz was saying, Harasho, very good. Good shot.
Perova draws it back.
That's
lands
good.
It on the line for an 8. You could see the difference on Perova's shot. Especially when you look back and think back to the Koreans, how far back they brought that string, to the nose, to the chin. Perova just back to the chin. Yes. Difference in styles.
The form of the Russian compared to the Asian is a bit different, and we received some question online that what's the difference in forms and technique? The Asian technique is a bit getting the answers online and working on expansion, not stopping too much at the answer point. When the European is a bit more stopping the answer point, getting the reference and start again shooting. And we can see clear differences.
It's noticeable, yes.
Yes, you can see it. Both works. Both have the positive and negative. And what is important that the archers make it consistent and believe in it.
Yes.
Confidently.
Confidence is everything.
We can see the side how it's moving, but archers need to keep expanding. Because even moving is not about aiming, it's about the reaction and the expansion and coordination of the shot. And very often people believe that this is about an aiming, the accuracy is in aiming. No, the accuracy is in the execution, in directing the shot to the center, not in fixing the sight in the center.
Laxmarani Maji warming up for her match this afternoon with that 10, and now followed up by Buruyuli with an 8.
You can start feeling the tension, eh?
Yes.
You can see the adrenaline, you can see the tension. And
there's tension on both sides.
Yes.
India anxious to wrap this up. Russia anxious to keep this going. Another 9 by Tuyana Dashidorjeva. 19 years old. Now here is the more experienced Perova. Ranked 77th in the world.
9.
Close.
I think it's a 9. Let's see what is happening.
That could be critical.
I think for us it's easy. We have a HD camera very close. We see the line for the spotter. We see it there. It's challenging sometimes.
70 meters away. Stepanova. Can she find the center circle? Yes, she does.
That's a good one. That's putting pressure to India. They cannot miss this yellow, and they better make a couple of 10. Let's see. Remove the star. It was a 9.
India can wrap this up. They can win the match with 3 strong shots right here. Maji.
She was We could see that. You saw my face.
Yes.
I was feeling it. It's too long, not determined, not confident. She rides the ball without being focused.
2 tens will tie and split. And give India the 1 point India needs, but it's not going to happen.
We can see what we discussed before. The confidence is gone. The pressure is getting into them.
India.
Russia managed to put them in a bad situation. They
planted some doubt.
Yep.
And Deepika Kumari trying to hold it together. But right now, she needs some help from her 2 teammates.
She needs to put them together. They need to pull back in the present. They need to forget what's happened before and work in what you have to do now. Here we see talking.
Easier said than done.
Yes. This is the time that you see the team is a team. When they support each other, when the one that's weak feel that the team is behind and is not responsible of a bad result, but is just part of the team and can make a difference. And normally, the team, the good team, is the one that the weakest archer, the one that is not informed, is not as good as the other, is performing well. So the team difference is about the weakest one, if he can feel or she can feel confident and supported by the teammate.
So this gold medal match here on Recurve Sunday in Copenhagen is going to go right down to the wire. It was India winning the first 2 sets to jump out to a 4-0 lead. Then Russia came back, won the 3rd set, cutting that lead in half, and won the 4th set as well to tie it up at 4 points apiece. This next set could determine the outcome. Of course, we could go to a shoot-off. That's always a possibility as well. If they tie in this set, it will go to a shoot-off.
We love shoot-offs.
We do love shoot-offs.
Not sure if the archers love it so much, but
we saw a great one yesterday in the men's gold medal match.
It's dramatic, it's exciting. It's what it's sport about.
Yes, it's got the fans on the edge of their seat.
The drama.
Everybody on edge right now. The pressure is on. Both India and the Russian Federation, although you have to think the Russian Federation is feeling a little bit better. They're coming on strong, and the momentum has definitely shifted right now.
Correct. We could see the technician for Falco Eye calibrating the system to make sure that this arrow we are really accurate. judges give an indication that the field is ready and we can shoot?
The Russian Federation ready to go. Stepanova, Parova, Dashidorjeva.
We can hear the heart beating from our sport position team to give a bit more drama even to
and
this.
And how fast are those hearts beating, Juan Carlos?
When you are there, it's too fast.
It's a million miles an hour right now. The trick is to slow that heart rate down. Dashidorjeva!
Wow, that's a good way.
What a start here in the fifth end.
You know, first we have to see the difference of point, but if they have the same point, we have to measure the distance to the center from the closest of each team. So this time was pretty close and good for the Russian team.
So we're tied in the tiebreaker.
Tying the score, but Russia is closer to the center. Let's see first how the score ends, and then if a measurement is needed.
Parova. Trying to put it in the center of the circle.
Silence in the stadium, silence here.
Everybody holding their breath as the second shot for Russia.
Definitely she
or
is
for
not
India,
confident.
Excuse me. Wound up in that aid ring.
Good face. Good timing.
Stepanova sticks it in the nine ring.
So, all depend on Deepika making a 10 and make it in the X ring.
Right, a better 10.
Make a 10, make it in the X, or you get a silver.
Will it be silver or will it be gold for India? It will be a silver for India. Russian Federation comes all the way back, forces a shoot-off. And in that shoot-off, they win by one, 28-27. Another thrilling comeback here at the World Championships.